Hey guys, welcome to the free video section of our website. So today we are going to discuss the difference between subquery and joins. For more details, you can also check our website ETL testing tutorial. If you have any query regarding the free video, then you can speak your mind under the QA section. Let us understand the concept of subqueries and joins individually. So first of all, if I talk about joins, basically, what are joins? Joins are those operations which will combine the data of two or more tables by combining their records. Okay, so first of all, as we know that joins are of many types, so I will explain about each of the joins one by one with their example. So first of all, let us discuss about inner join. What do we mean by inner join? See, basically, when we perform inner join between two or more tables, it will provide us the common data as our result. See, here let us assume that this is table 1 and this one is table 2. And here when we performed inner join, then it, or we can also say self join. Whenever we perform inner or self join, it will provide us the common records as our result. Let us see how. So here I have taken an example of two tables. I have created table 1 and table 2. Within table 1, I am having four columns: article number, name, price, manufacturer ID. And within table 2, I am having manufacturer ID and manufacturer. As you can see, the table 1 is containing 5 records and the second table is containing around 3 records. Now, if I perform inner join between both of them, what will happen? See, if you check what all rows are similar or common between both of these tables. See, the manufacturer ID column is common between both of these tables, and if I talk about the rows, there are 3 rows that are common between both of them. So what I'll get as my result? I'll get the details of these 3 rows from both of these tables whenever I'll perform inner join. Okay, let me show you. See, here I have also provided you the query to create the table and I have inserted these all records. And now when I'll perform inner join, so for performing inner join, what you need to do is you need to go with the select query. You can also perform inner join with the help of select, delete or create command. Okay, different statements. I'll also tell you about them. So here, see, select article number, article name, price column, which is coming from table 1. Okay, so these all columns are coming from table 1. And then I'm saying that table 2 dot manufacturer ID, table 2 dot manufacturer is coming from table 2, right? And then I'm performing inner join with table 2 on the basis of this common column that is present in both of these tables. I'm saying that I want to perform inner join between table 1 and table 2 on the basis of manufacturer ID, wherever the manufacturer ID of table 1 is similar to the manufacturer ID of table 2, I want to get or fetch those records. If I execute this, let me connect first with the SQL Management Studio and see, I'm getting my result. Here I'm getting only 3 records. Why? Because these 3 rows were common between both of the tables. Right? So this is how you can perform inner join. Now if I talk about the next join, that is let us go with outer join. Now what outer join will do? Outer join will provide us the data from the first table, second table, as well as the common data will be given to us. That means full outer join provides us the data from all the tables that are combined. Fine. Now let us see how we can perform outer join. Let me first label this. And if I go to my SQL Management Studio, see, full outer join, the same query is coming. Article number, name, price, column is coming from table 1. Then I selected table 2 dot manufacturer ID, and the manufacturer is also coming from table 2, and this time I'm using full outer join with table 2 on the basis of common column. So if I execute this, I'm getting this time 5 records. Why? Because the outer join will provide us the data from all the tables, the whole data from all the tables. Fine. Now if I talk about left join, basically what left join does, if we take the concept of left join, left join will provide us the records that is present in the left hand side table. Fine. That means I'll get the data from that very table which is present in the left hand side. So let us see how we can perform that. See here what I'm doing, I'm selecting all the records. Wait a minute. I'm selecting article number, name, price column, all the records from the table 1, and I'm also selecting the manufacturer ID from table 2. Whenever you are selecting any other data from any other table, then you need to go with the dot operator, fine. So I'm selecting all the columns from table 1 and this column from table 2, and then I'm performing left join. So which table is on the left hand side? Table 1 is on the left hand side. So this time I'll get all the records from table 1. And if I execute this, see, I'm getting around 5 records. Why? Because these 5 rows were present in the table 1, and here I'm getting null for this. But I'm not getting that very column which is present in table 2. Which one? Manufacturer. I'm not getting that very column. If you check, let me show you table 2. See, here I'm containing manufacturer ID and manufacturer, but when I'm performing the left join, sorry, this one, left join, I'm not getting that manufacturer column. Right, but I'm getting 5 records. Why 5 rows are provided? Because the table 1 is containing 5 rows. On the other hand, if we go with right join, let us see the concept of right join first. Within right join, we will get the data from the right hand side table. Right, that means this one. So this one is, let me label this. This one is right join. So now what we'll do, we'll go with table 1 right join, table 2, right? So this time I'll get all the records from this table, that is table 2. Let us see how we can perform this. I'm selecting all the records from table 1, and then I'm performing right join with table 2 on the basis of this common column. And if I go with this, see, I'm getting only 3 records. Why? Because these 3 rows are common in right hand side table, table 2. I'm not getting the records that are present in table 1 or that is not common to this table. Fine. See, I'm getting manufacturer ID, manufacturer. These records are present in, if you check, these all records are present in table 2. Because I'm performing right join, that means I'm getting the data according to these rows, according to the details of these rows. See, 101 is present within this table also. That's why I'm getting the details for this record. 102 is also present, so I'm getting the details for that. Got it? So this was how we can perform joins. Now, if I talk about queries or subqueries, so how we can perform subqueries? Basically, if you are familiar with any programming language, you must know that what do we mean by nested loop. See, whenever we provide a loop, under a loop, this is a for loop, and I'm providing a for loop under a for loop. So this is known as nested loop, right? Similarly, like this, if I provide a query within a query, then that will be known as nested query, fine, or subquery. So here what we'll do basically, let us assume that we are having two tables. Okay, these are some records, there are some records in table 1 and there are some records in table 2. Fine. Now, what if I want to fetch the data from this table 1 with the help of this table 2 without joining both of them? So here within joins we were combining the tables for fetching the records, for fetching the common records. But here we can fetch the records without joining the tables. Fine, we can get the data of one table with the help of another table without joining them. Now let us see how we can do that. I'll take the same example so that you can evaluate the things. Like see, if I go with select star from table 1 and 2. Within table 1, I'm having 5 records. Fine. And within table 2, I'm having 3 records. So let us go with this query. Select star from table 1 where the manufacturer ID is. You must be familiar with the select query because this was very simple one. So I'm saying that I want to select all the records from table 1 wherever the manufacturer ID is. So instead of providing the manufacturer ID, I'm again providing another query. I'm going with select manufacturer ID from table 2. This time I'm swapping with another table. I'm not switching to the same table. I'm going with another table, that is table 2. I'm saying that I want to select the manufacturer ID from this table 2 wherever the manufacturer is Zebronix. So first of all, here what is happening basically? Bottom-up approach is happening. Within data warehouses, we will go with bottom-up approach, top-down approach. Similarly like this, the query is performing in the bottom-up approach process, or it is following the bottom-up approach process. The server will first go to this table 2. It will provide the manufacturer ID from that very record wherever the manufacturer is Zebronix. That means the ID is 103. And this very ID will be applied over here after the equal to operator. Fine. And then the query will get executed and the result will be provided. Fine. Now let us see by executing this. See, I'm getting this record from table 1. But first the server selected this query. It executed this. It provided the result over here. Then it executed this much. So similarly like this, you can not only use the equal to operator. You can also use any other operator like in operator, exist operator, or less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to. Like if I go with in operator over here, see the same result has been given. Right? You can also go with exist. So hope you have understood the concept of subqueries and joins, and thank you for joining.